Hi, my name is Martin and welcome to my chess channel. Today I'm going to continue my series on the King's Indian defense and how to win against it with the London system. And I think I found a really interesting new move against this the King's Indian defense. And if you haven't watched the introduction, please find it in the playlist. And in the first video, I looked at the line d4, knight f6, bishop f4, the London system. And now black plays g6, knight c3, going to look at the center and making ready to play e4. And now bishop g7. And sometimes black plays d5 here. This is the main line, but this video series is not covering this line, but we are focusing on g7 primarily. So, and this is also played a lot of times online. So here white plays e4. And now we looked at the line d6, queen e2, the interesting move I'm looking at in this series. And here, after castle queenside, black has several moves. And the last video I looked at knight c6, and here I proposed the move e5, and then I looked at the move knight d7. But I would also like to show what happens if black plays knight to h5, which is also a possible move to play in this variation, attacking the bishop. And here the best move is actually just to move back the bishop to e3. And here you can see that this knight actually doesn't have so many squares to move to, and the threat of playing g4 is quite troublesome for black. So this is maybe because this is why this is not the best move, but I've encountered it several times playing it, and I have won quite a handful of games where this knight is trapped and taken after playing g4. So it's really nice knowing what to do in this kind of variation. And here after e3, black can try to take on e5, but here white can take back with e5, and now after queen e8, g4 is a winning move for white, since the knight is trapped. So it does not work. Another option is to play, let's see, f6, trying to stop the white center. And after e takes d6, queen takes d6, g4, now attacking the knight again, and bishop f4. Now the queen protects the knight, and now white can play queen f3, attacking the knight again. And now black has to defend the knight or move it away. And after g5 protecting the knight, white can simply play e4, and this position is really nice for white. Another option would be to play the knight back to e6, And here white can play knight to b5, attacking the queen. And after the queen moves to, for example, b4, then a3, attacking the queen again, and e5, queen to a5. And now h4 is a really good move. And black has a strong attack here on the king side. And black hasn't really gotten his pieces into to action. So, and this bishop is blocked in, and this bishop is blocked in, and this knight is blocking the pawn here, and yeah, it's not a very good position for black. So now we have looked at how to play if, let's see, we were at this point. If in the introduction video I looked at knight to d7, but here in this video we will look at knight to h5. And yeah, it's really a pleasant move, because when you move the bishop back and you have this threat of g4, this knight can often just be taken, or it will lead to a really interesting attack for white. So please, if you like this video and want to follow the rest of the series, please support my channel and subscribe. And if you have any questions to the variation, please leave a comment, and I will promise you that I will write back to you. See you next time. Bye.